serious, what are some men's issues that are overlooked? The fact that people ridicule and laugh at you for having depression is something we all need to talk about. It isn't funny. Depression is real, and the fact that so many are choosing to keep it within is simply disturbing. Isolation. Many men have no friends. More so, they don't know how to find meaningful friendships. It's incredibly difficult to know where to even begin. Marizo, if you're not in college or school, I'm 24, almost 25, and never had an emotional outlet. I don't even know what that looks like in a healthy sense. The first relationship I had, I believe I ruined, because I put too much of what I had been carrying for so long on that person, as patient and as caring as they were. Insecurity in general. You're not supposed to show that you have doubts or worries about your abilities or self-image. A man is supposed to be confident, able, and self-assured. It's not okay for men to admit that they lack self-esteem or that they have genuine problems with their self-image, as they are seen as weaknesses in and of themselves. Other men or women aren't going to bring you up. They won't provide emotional support and tell you it's okay to be unconfident or to feel shame about who you are. They will simply expect that you should take it on the chin. Not everyone can be that guy, but for a man, what actually makes you feel like a man is being that guy. So you kind of walk around pretending that you're happy, despite the fact that you're not seen as valuable or as desirable as other men, because in doing so, you would be seen as even less valuable or desirable. Too long didn't read. If you feel like shit and are insecure, it's bad, but if you display that you feel like shit and are insecure, it's even worse. Duck, I've never really been able to put that feeling into words before, but that felt insanely good to get off my chest. Isolation. I felt this myself, and I've done some reading about it. Men tend to become more isolated and lonely as they get older. After a certain point, they don't make an effort to gain friendships and tend to shy away from any type of social engagement. I feel this way because as of right now, I don't have a close male friend. At least not someone I can talk to about things going on with me personally. I know a lot of people, but I'm less and less engaged with them as each year passes. It concerns me as of late because I don't want to end up a hermit. But without a solid relationship, I could see myself headed this direction in my older years. Hello from the other side. I'm 57. When I was younger, I told myself that I didn't need other people, and that's still largely true. Today I don't have any close friends. The odd thing is, people like me, they tell me that they think of me as a friend, but not one of them would consider me their best friend. If anyone were to ask me to do something with them or for them, I would. I have, however, I rarely ask myself. When I do, the results are hit and miss. I know that everyone's priorities are different. Everyone's work and life balance isn't the same. Jobs and kids get in the way, and friendships are sometimes a lower priority. But when you're my age, many of those issues are already resolved. In all likelihood, your kids are grown, and you've probably reached as high a level as you're going to in your career. Yeah. There are always exceptions. By my age, you're probably established enough and comfortable enough to do pretty much whatever you want. Yet here I am. Not exactly lonely, but alone. I wonder if things might have been different if I'd had a different attitude towards my solitude when I was younger. Reading the stories from others here, I'm starting to believe that things wouldn't have been. Which makes me wonder if it's the culture that's at fault. Hopefully we'll get more responses from outside the US or UK. I'm retired now. Time to start a new life on a beach somewhere. I might still be alone, but at least the scenery will be great. 58 here. I have almost the same story as you. I have friends but not close. It seems I have to initiate catch-ups, etc. When I needed people after my divorce, only my eldest brother was really there for me. I spent a lot of time on my own. I have made a determined effort now to reach out to other people. I notice they are happy for me to organize things, but as soon as I stop, I don't hear from them. I think people think older men just don't have feelings and are happy to be by themselves. Loneliness. Crushing. Black. Empty. Cold. Never ending. Screaming into the void loneliness and everyone's casual shrug when I even hint about it. Just work. Pay taxes. Walk the dog. Keep your mouth shut. Don't have feelings. Don't be short. Try to keep up appearances of virility. And never, ever, whatever you do, don't let anyone know how lonely you are, because they'll just sort of awkwardly giggle and change the subject. Abuse from women other men. We are told to just take it and toughen up. It builds character, puts hair on the chest, etc. And we don't need support or a helping hand. Duck that. I work at a psychiatric hospital, and out of the 13 wards, only 3 are for women. The huge problem to face men is mental illness, and most, if not all, the patients are there because they kept taking drugs as well. The lack of a good support system. Just because a guy has people that he hangs out with doesn't mean he's comfortable telling them serious personal issues. I don't the accuracy of the statement, but I read that majority of men between ages 14-35 are lonely. I can speak for myself, and that's true. It had been more than a year I had any human interaction outside my family. Even though your family has your back, but you don't tell them all the things you are going through, just because you don't want to bother them with your problems, because you feel your problems don't matter, and you should be able to face it on your own. For the last 6 plus years I've lived alone with my 2 dogs. I worked on a small farm until recently, nearly 14 years. My closest friend is 600 miles away, and my big C's is 1000 miles away. I have really little human interaction and none meaningful, just talking to people for a minute in the store or on walks. I cut my family out of my life because I was tired of being used and unwanted. I have 3 people I'm close to online, including those 2, but that's basically it. I'm 34 and lonely as heck, and suffer from anxiety and depression. In Western culture, men are defined by what they do and not by who they are being. So, when they retire, they often develop mental illness because they are no longer doing. This often leads to suicide. Then there's the whole nonsense of the stoic emotionless man getting on with the work. Not even always suicide. A lot of times they just sit in a chair, turn on the TV, and waste away. I work in the steel industry, and the amount of guys that retire and you hear about them dying a couple years later is crazy. All these guys knew from pretty much 17, 18 years old was working as much as possible. Once that's over, they pretty much just sit around and drink themselves to death. Emotional abuse of men. My BF suffered that in both his marriages, and I'm so careful to not say or do anything that could make him feel the way they made him feel. I try very hard to be sure he knows I value him for who he is, just the way he is, every single day. Even he doesn't know how much damage they caused him. I will never get over this 1950s assumption that women can't abuse men. Women abuse men way more often than anyone realizes, and the system is stacked against men in so many different ways. Edit: I've only been on Reddit for 2 days, so I don't understand the reward system. But thank you. Edit 2: I woke up to a ton of responses, and I've got to clean my house today, so I probably won't respond to many more of them. But I clearly hit a nerve with this comment. To the men who have been emotionally abused, I'm so sorry, and I would encourage all of you to seek therapy. It really does help. To the women who love them, don't stop loving them. So I'm at the park playing tag with these kids I'm babysitting, and out of nowhere this old lady comes up to me and starts asking all sorts of questions. Do you know these kids? What are their names? Can you call their parents for me? Even asking the kids if they knew me, and when they answered yes, she responded with, "You don't have to lie. If you don't know this man, you can tell me and I can help you." Just last week I was at the park with my 2-year-old daughter, and a bunch of moms were sitting at a bench chatting about 30 feet away. This girl, about 2 is playing with my daughter, climbing all over the stuff and doing pretty good for young kids, and gets sort of stuck on a ladder and asks me for help down. So I grab her and set her down. She says "thank you" and then runs over to the car thing my daughter is climbing up. So I follow them, like I have been doing for the last hour. During this hour, no other parent guardian has moved from the benches. Then one comes over to me and says, "Sorry, but could you not stay so close to my daughter and don't touch her again? I'm not following your kid around. I'm following mine. Your kid was stuck on a ladder. Should I just let her fall next time?" "Well, no. But, well, then you have to be there if she falls. That's probably the third time that's happened to me in the last few months. I get it, and I appreciate the concern, but it's pretty annoying. Well, then you have to be there if she falls. But then they can't just sit on their ass and stare into their phone for hours. Think, Mark. Think. So this one might not be as serious as the others. I babysit my friend's kids all the time. One is 3 and the other is 11. I like to take them out and about to have some fun. We go eat food. We go to the park. And arcades too. We have a ton of fun. But I always get weird looks from people. They don't look like me at all, because I'm not the father. I've had people interrogate me, and it's weird to me. I've been there their entire life and treat them like my own kids. So it kinda hurts. Edit, well shit. I guess it's more serious than I thought. That one is so terrible. Men just can't be around children without being looked at weird. Regardless of their relationship. Except if you are clearly their father or a woman is with you. Your kids can be literal clones of you, and still get weird old looks in the parks and such. Because so many people perpetuate this idea that all men are pedos hunting kids. It's odd because it does vary with activity too. If I'm biking with my daughter, it's seen as a cool bonding activity. If we walk to the park down the road, I'm a weirdo. Me too. It's also child gender specific. Strangers are more likely to look intervene if the child is a girl. It's as if they think little boys do not need as much protecting. Mental health. And this is coming from someone who has lived on the ideas of you're a guy. Get over yourself. It was taught to me. I didn't think much of it. And now that I'm about to hit 20, I can feel the effects like a ripple. It's actually hard for me to open up to people. And when I do, I feel like I'm wasting everyone's time. Edit, I appreciate all of the upvotes. As time goes on. And if more people see this, I'll read everything you all have replied with. I one day hope to have the courage to seek help for myself. Until then though, I hope you all have a wonderful day, and seek to make tomorrow a better day than today. You can't cry. You can't have emotional issues. You are supposed to know the answer to all problems. Men who are victims of sexual assault, rape, domestic abuse, male suicide rates, and depression. I'm late to the party, so this will get lost. But in my experience, it feels like dudes are expected to work 70 plus hour weeks and be proud of it, or else they're lazy. Like, no a-hole here. I'm going to be working at least 65 hours next week between two jobs, which is ducking plenty, and that includes both daytime and overnight shifts. If I complain for even a sentence though, I'm going to be shit-talked by the crew when they think I can't hear them. I'm tired. I like doing things that aren't work. That shit just isn't sustainable for some people. A really big one is abuse. Sexual assault or rape isn't taken seriously when it happens to men. The miserable paternity leaves. Cause what man wants to spend time with his newborn kid and a recovering wife, right? My country just raised it from 3 days to 2 weeks within 6 months after the birth, which still isn't a lot. Loneliness. Many men tend to have a lot of friends, but never close friends or people they feel like truly care about them, which leads to declining mental health, and maybe worse. Especially not relationships in which you can talk mental health and that deep emotional stuff. I feel lucky to have at least a couple people in my life who listen to such issues. Only because they experience mental issues as well, and because I do my best to destigmatize mental illness in my everyday life. There are almost always more shelters available to women experiencing homelessness. In my city, the split is about 75% beds for women and children and 25% for men. I understand that society considers women more vulnerable, but I live in a city where it routinely gets below zero in the winter. Hypothermia doesn't care about your gender. Erectile dysfunction. It seems like a joke, but guys literally kill themselves because of it. It's like losing the ability to love, losing your manhood, losing your ability to feel intimate with someone. After my wife cheated on me, she had done it multiple times throughout our 21-year marriage. The anxiety was horrible. Yes, it happens, and either you can't get an erection or you're so in your head during sex that you lose it midway. You're very turned on. You're into it. You love it. But your brain is saying you're not good enough. Silas helps. but damn, does it really affect your manhood? WTF. Kind of a hidden one that's clouded by many of today's norms and cultural values. But the concept of disposability with men and many things that make them individual beings. Male pattern baldness and the impact it can have on mental health and body image. Imagine being in college surrounded by guys with perfect NW1 hairlines with all these cool fades and modern trendy hairstyles, while you're stuck looking like Moby or Varys from GOT. Brutal. The worst part is nobody really talks about it. It's a very hidden and taboo issue that many men go through, but society refuses to truly address, so they are forced to suffer in silence. Male disposability. If something is dangerous, send men. Your partner can replace you easily. Your only value is what you offer to other people, and the minute you are not useful anymore, people cast you aside like the fungible commodity you are. I would like to be treated like I have inherent value as a person, not like I'm something to be tolerated until I'm no longer useful. Mental health. Oftentimes men are made to believe mental health struggles show weakness or vulnerability, when in reality it is not something they can control. I'm a single father with primary custody of a school-aged child with little social support in my area. I was also the stay-at-home parent while I went back to college and completed my degree. It is damn near impossible to find good childcare. My female work friends volunteer, but then bail at the last minute. I'm looked at as a threat by husbands of my son's classmate parents. I find that I'm often the only guy at the playground and get sideways glances from the cliques of women who go there. If I hire a babysitter, I have to make sure I'm overly cautious about respecting boundaries if I'm even able to have a babysitter watch my child. Also, the normal competition among female mothers gets amplified, and I'm often looked down on as a parent. I don't fit in with working guys who just want to go out and get a beer because I have a child to take care of, and women often reject me on online dating sites simply because I have a child. I love my son and would do anything in the world for him. I feel like I've done a lot, but men in my situation have zero to little support or infrastructure to manage as a single, full-time parent in society. Men can be just as good parents as women, and society needs to normalize this pronto. Edit, I probably won't be able to address all the comments, there were way more than I expected, but I really appreciate all the feedback and support.